Hi, Meatloaf here. Talk Sport Magazine. You're watching. And Jack Black was going to play me, and I'm the one who suggested him. And we had him. He agreed to do it. And then I said, well, you got to do it now because this guy, his star is going to take off and he's going to get busy. So if you didn't do it, you need to like get it set up. Well, they moaned and pissed and moved around and took him 9 months. And by the 9 months, I said, you're losing him. And all of a sudden, bam, he got some movie and I was gone. And the guy who played me was fine, but he was not Jack. So then Jack said after that, oh, Meat's going to play my father. And so that went around for about 10 years, I think. And finally, I said, well, when Jack calls me up on the phone and says that he wants me to play his father, I'll play it. So one Sunday, I'm sitting at home, and the phone rings, and you hear, Meat, Jack. What was Jack Black? And he goes, I want you to play my father. I said, done. I was going on, what was it, Soccer AM, and they said, do you you have a team that you support, like Manchester United, Liverpool? And I'm going, that's boring. Why, it's just like a celebrity to go on and go, oh yeah, I'm a Liverpool fan. I'm a man, I support whoever, you know, the teams that are in the lead, like it's always been up at the top. So I started looking, and I went to the second division. No, and I go down third division, and so I go, well, that's a cool name, Hartlepool, in the third division, right? And I found out that the city, back a long time ago, the claim was that a monkey washed ashore, and the whole city thought it was a Frenchman, and they hung him. And I said, that's perfect. And so then what I did was I started researching all the players in Hartlepool. So when I got on Saturday AM, I knew all the players. I knew the last game. I knew who was the big scorers. I knew who the coach was. And I got on the phone with the Hartlepool coach, and I told him, yeah, hang in there. You'll move up, I guarantee you. And since then, I am a member of the, I've signed up for the web, left them my email address, and I get Hartlepool updates. I mean, these people are into it. So I couldn't tell you what was going on in the field. I was watching everybody else going, oh, what's the song they sing? And all this is like the other morning, the other day on Sunday, it was my day off and I was trying to sleep in. And there's a sports bar across the street from me and they were out there. I'm going, what in the hell is going on? And I'm going, oh, football. Okay, I'll leave them alone. Football games are no match to like going to an English soccer game and the fans dressing and they have the colors and the thing. Everybody does, not just a couple of guys. Because I pulled a fast one. I stole from, there's a famous baseball player in America named Billy Martin. And in a professional game when he was coaching Oakland, he had a runner start from first going to second and fall down and grab his leg and start going, oh, oh, God, I'm dying. And there was a man on third. So they threw the ball out there and the guy from third scored the winning run. How stupid was the other team? So I did the same thing. I went, okay, now, Sarah, you're going to take off from first. She goes, oh, I can't do that. I said, Sarah, you're going to take off from first. You're going to fall, and you're going to scream and yell like your leg is killing you. And we're going to score this run. We're going to beat them. And they did. Oh, they tried to protest it. They tried to find every rule in the book. The other coach was out there with a rule book. The umpires were out there with a rule book. Umpires went, there's nothing in the rule says he can't do that. I just got a seat from Yankee Stadium, from old Yankee Stadium, signed by Yankees, a Yankee from the 50s, a Yankee from the 60s, a Yankee from the 70s, because the 40s hard to get. I just got a hockey stick signed by Gretzky and Messier, And that was given to my wife, actually, because we know Gretzky and Messier, but that's not how I got it. I could have gotten stuff from Gretzky, and just because I was friendly with him, played golf with him, would be like him turning to me going, can I have an autograph for your wall, my wall? I mean, he's not going to do that. And Wayne, can I get a hockey stick? You know, it ain't going to happen. Most of the stuff that's worth anything has been given to me, like the football helmets by Elway and Dan Marino and Jim Kelly and Troy Donahue, Bernie Kosar. They were all given to me. Marino's was game-worn helmet. And in his last game, actually. It was a helmet he wore in his last game. It was his backup helmet and his first helmet. The strap broke for a few minutes, and he ran about 12 plays in his backup helmet, and he gave it to me.